Hi, everyone. I'm Mindy Egan, and I'm excited to introduce to you the Pretty Pink Posh September 2023 release. We'll start out by taking a look at the four new embellishment packs this month. This contains an assortment of 4, 5, and 6 millimeter sizes. The first pack we have here is the Espresso Mix. You can see these are confetti, so there's no hole in the center of them. They're great for attaching to the front of your projects. Next, we have the Matte Silver Confetti Mix, which has a beautiful shine, but the shine is toned down a little bit with that matte finish. Next, we have the Matte Gold Confetti Mix. So you can see this isn't a super yellow gold. It is very toned down, almost brassy looking, which is very pretty for fall. And next, we have the Mossy Green Confetti Mix, a beautiful green color that is perfect for all of your fall projects and shaker carts. Next, we'll take a look at stamp sets. So we have three new fall-themed stamp sets to share with you. Starting with the Sentiment Strips Fall Stamp Set, this contains 14 sentiments, including things like fall greetings, thankful for you, happy Thanksgiving, sending heartfelt thanks, happy fall, and many more. Then we have the Fall Jar. This one is a 4x6 stamp set that includes 17 designs, and there is a coordinating die you can purchase separately that includes 14 dies. Now, the dies do cut out all of the images except the sentiments, and the sentiments include autumn greetings, thankful for you, and happy fall. You can see how adorable it would be to decorate the inside or outside of this fall jar, maybe add a greeting. You have some critters that you can add around the jar, and then even a little tag with a bow. Next, we have the Autumn Pumpkins stamp set. This is a 4x6 stamp set that includes 13 designs and 13 dies that you can purchase separately. So that means there is a die for every image in this stamp set, including the autumn greetings sentiment. So there are lots of great different pumpkins on here, or depending how you color them up, they could be gourds. We also have three new fall-themed stencils to share with you. First, we have the Deco Leaves. These are 6x6 stencils. This is a single layer stencil, and I think this would be really cute to use as maybe a sweater pattern. You could do tone on tone ink blending to create that look. Then we have the Layered Wreath Stencil. This one is a two-piece layering stencil. The first layer we have creates the leaves that go all the way around in a circle. The second layer creates the veins of the leaves. This stencil looks beautiful layering up your colors or using a single color for your leaves. And then we have the Layered Woodland Stencil. This one is a four-piece stencil. The first layer is for the leaves. The second layer, when you add it on top, is going to have some additional little leaf branches. There is going to be a topper for a mushroom and then also the bottom of an acorn. The third layer of the stencil is going to bring in the topper for the acorn, the stem for your mushroom, and a couple other additional leaves to fill in some of those spaces. And then your fourth layer for the stencil is going to give you the spots for your mushroom, the little topper piece for your acorn, the little stem, and then also the veins for your leaves. And you can see once I added all those colors, what a beautiful woodsy scene that creates. We have six new standalone dies and one new hot foil plate to share with you. Starting with the Thankful Shadow. So this one is a two-piece set. You have the scripty word and also the shadow layer. This measures just under 4 inches long. You can die cut and use the scripty portion all on its own, or add on top of your shadow layer to add some dimension. To coordinate with this, we have the Thankful Hot Foil Plate. So you can hot foil this using your Glimmer hot foil system and the specialty glimmer foil. I foiled this one out of a brown glimmer foil. You can use this on its own, or you can pick up the shadow die to die cut out your sentiment. Next, we have this really fun acorn shaker. So this measures about 3x4. I die cut mine out of the center of a piece of white cardstock. Now you can use this separately or to create a shaker card. Now it's going to cut out all the pieces at once. So we have an outline piece, then we have the inside piece and your acorn topper. I'm going to layer these pieces back up over that negative space that I have from my cardstock so you can see how it would look on the front of a card just using it as is. Or if you want to turn it into a shaker, you would back your cardstock panel with acetate, and then you could layer these pieces on top and fill the area behind it with a shaker mix. Next, we have these stitched torn rectangles. This is a 4-piece set, the largest measuring 4 1/8 by 5 1/4, and the smallest measuring about 2 by 3 inches. You can see as I lay these pieces out, it's got that really neat kind of torn edge look, and then it also has some stitching that goes just inside the border. You can use each of these layers individually, or you can stack them up for a really fun look. And another thing I wanted to show you that I think is going to be really fun is if you die cut this and center it out of a piece of cardstock, you can use this as a border to add on top of your card project, or use as a stencil, an ink blend, a torn frame. This is the Pumpkin Shaker. So this is a 4-piece die set that measures about 2 3/4 by 3 inches. You can see we have a base piece that gives some stitching detail. If you take this other piece and place it over the top, you can create a stitched frame. So you can use these individually. You can use this to create your shaker. You can take that stitched or that outline and add it over the top. Lots of possibilities with this one. And it also includes a stem and a leaf to decorate your pumpkin. Now we have the Fall Cornucopia set. This is an 11-piece die set, great for all of your fall-themed projects. Now starting out, we have a pumpkin and its stem, this really cute layering mushroom. There's also some leaves on here and the grapes. I wanted to point out the stem on a lot of these pieces has the stem on top and then kind of that circle towards the bottom. And that's just to help you attach the stem a little easier. Now, most of these, like the grapes, the pumpkin, the pears, you're going to be able to die cut this out of 2 different colors of cardstock or 3, depending on the image you have. And it's small enough where both of the pieces are in one set. So for instance, the pumpkin and the stem is combined. You don't have to cut those apart. So we have the grapes, the sunflower, we have some wheat stalks. We also have some corn, so you can do a corn stalk or just the regular corn on the cob. This one I had die cut and turned it into an eggplant, but after reading some descriptions, I believe it's supposed to be squash, so left out there for interpretation, whatever you need for your projects. We also have a pear that I die cut out of just a couple different colors of cardstock. And then you have your large cornucopia where you can add all of these fun images into that. And you can add a little ink blending to your images to give it some more dimension. Now we have the fall mug editions. So this is meant to be paired with the winter mug, which is sold separately, but you can also use these pieces individually on your projects. The fall mug editions is an 11-piece die set. So here we have a sunflower. There is a scarf that you can layer up and cut out in any color to add to your winter mug. There is a cinnamon stick. We also have a couple different variety of leaves. There is also this really cute mushroom. So when you die cut out the mushroom, it cuts all of these pieces out at once. So you'll need to die cut it from various colors of cardstock. And then you can just layer this up together. Then we also have a marshmallow that you can add to a stirring stick. So that and the cinnamon stick you can put either outside or inside of your mug. Then we also have the sentiment cozy days, an acorn, and then we have this little branch that you can die cut out in green and then add some berries into those areas. I just did mine out of a white glitter cardstock for the berries. And then we have this super cute critter. So this is designed to be a squirrel, but I think it can be into a fox or a bear, really anything just by changing up some colors. So what I had done is I die cut the head out of 2 different colors of cardstock. I did a kind of a light vanilla color and I did an orange. And then you have its topper piece that's going to give you the outline for its face. So what I'll do is add some tape runner to the top of that piece. I'm going to add it to the top of the head with that light color cardstock, and then I'm just going to trim off the ears, and then I can add this onto the head base. So what that'll do is you can see how we have the ears the same color as the head, and then you still have the frame for the face. Now we have some pieces for the ears to give pink to the ears. There's 2 different types of eyes. You can have one as plain circles or one as eyelashes, and then the nose and the mouth. And now you can take all of these pieces and really just have fun decorating up your winter mugs, depending what you want to do. If you want to add a cute little scarf, maybe pop in some of the cinnamon sticks, have some fall leaves maybe trailing down or around. You can also take this cute critter and add it to the front or even to the top of the mug if you want to get really cutesy. We also have dies where you can turn these mugs into shaker cards. The mugs are always so fun to create and customize. I hope you enjoyed today's closer look at the September 2023 release from Pretty Pink Posh. Thanks for joining us today.